Well, the new movie, The Banker, follows the story of two black entrepreneurs who open a bank during the height of segregation. They run the business all while posing as a janitor and chauffeur. Fox 4's Sean Edwards chats with the stars about what it took to bring this tale to the big screen.
How would you like to buy a bank?
What the hell do we know about banking?
Owning a bank is like owning the other side of the real estate business.
There's a few complexities you just left out.
Like what?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I not wake up black this morning? Because I'm pretty sure I did. Yep, still black.
Two Marvel Avengers, Anthony Mackie and Samuel Jackson, play real-life Avengers in the movie The Banker. Mackie and Jackson play two unlikely civil rights activists who fought the fight to change discriminatory housing policies during the height of segregation in the 50s and 60s. I attended the world premiere screening at the National Civil Rights Museum at the Lorraine Motel in Memphis, Tennessee, where I got a chance to talk with the cast and director George Nofi about his Hidden Figures story.
You know, getting it made is probably the thing I'm most proud of. It's such an uphill climb to get any film made. You know, and as I've said a couple times here, getting something made about banking and about housing with two African American leads, it's just, you know, it's not the thing that Hollywood does like that.
I asked the stars of the film what other little-known stories they would want to tell.
I think it's about time we have enough stars, we have enough young actors of notoriety for the story of Black Wall Street to be told. I think if we all humble ourselves and come together, we have enough amazing writers, we have enough dynamic directors, we have enough financial stability within our film community to have that movie made and own it.
You know, my family's from the Caribbean, and there's a lot of history of the Africans being traded to the Caribbean and how they landed in Grenada, and that's why Grenada was given the title the Spice Island, because the Europeans would come and they would steal all the spices. They'd take them back to Europe. So I think there's probably something really interesting there to be discussed and explored.
This is the story of students in Orangeburg, South Carolina that got killed in the system.
Let's do that. Let's make it happen.
We should.
If this was easy, somebody else would have done it a long time ago.
Sean Edwards, Fox 4 News.
You and revolution.
Coming up, Fox 4 News at 8. We're tracking the coronavirus and the toll it's taken on the economy and the metro. Plus, we're giving you 5 ways to stay informed and entertained if you're staying in this weekend.